Fairytales, Peter Pan. It is bedtime in the Darling House. Wendy tucks her little brother Michael into bed. Every night she reads him a story to help him get to sleep. Tonight I'll read The Little Red Hen, says Wendy. Suddenly, they hear a tinkle of tiny little bells. Was that you, Michael? Says Wendy. He shakes his head. Let's read The Little Porridge Pot instead, she says. But the tiny little bells tinkle once more. It's not Michael, that's for sure. Where are those little bells coming from? They follow the sound and it leads them to a little mouse hole. As they peer inside, something very curious happens. The little mouse hole begins to grow bigger and bigger until there's just enough room to crawl through to the other side. Wendy and Michael can hardly believe that such a wonderful place could be hidden just behind the skirting board of their very ordinary bedroom. A little boy comes to greet them.
I'm Peter Pan, he says. Welcome to Neverland.
Peter Pan just loves to listen to Wendy's stories every night through the mouse hole. And here comes Tinkerbell. She loves to listen to Wendy's stories too. It was her little voice they heard. When she speaks, it sounds just like tiny little bells. Mean old Captain Hook has banned storytelling in Neverland. So it is the only time Peter Pan and Tinkerbell ever get to hear any stories. But Wendy has brought a storybook with her. They are so excited. They gather round to listen. Wendy must be very quiet so Captain Hook doesn't hear. But just as she starts to read, Captain Hook marches through the jungle with his shipmate, Smee. What have I told you about stories, Peter Pan? Shouts Captain Hook. No one breaks my rules and gets away with it. He captures poor Wendy. She is very frightened. Peter Pan desperately tries to rescue her, but he just can't get past that shiny, sharp hook. All of a sudden, Captain Hook looks very scared indeed. That tick-tock, tick-tock is no ordinary clock. A hungry crocodile wears it around his neck, and he wants to gobble up Captain Hook. Quickly, Smee! Back to the Jolly Roger, he shouts. Luckily for Captain Hook, the crocodile moves very slowly on land.
He thinks the crocodile wants to eat him, says Peter Pan with a giggle.
And this gives him a very good idea. They huddle together and he whispers his plan. Michael and Tinkerbell promise to help. Peter gives Michael a shiny new sword. Now they are ready to do battle with the pirates. Poor Wendy is tied to the mast of the Jolly Roger with Captain Hook and Smee keeping guard. It's time for Peter Pan to put his plan into action. He starts to tick, just like the crocodile. Captain Hook is so frightened. He runs up and down the ship, looking everywhere for the crocodile. Peter Pan sneaks aboard with Michael and Tinkerbell.
there's no fooling Captain Hook.
How dare you play a trick on me,
he snarls. Peter Pan and Michael draw their swords. They bravely do battle with the pirates. Tinkerbell unties Wendy from the mast. She's so happy to be free. But Peter and Michael have been cornered by the pirates. They must save them. Tinkerbell flies high up into the air with a cannonball. Then she drops it straight through the deck. It makes a terrible crash, and the ship floods with water. Captain Hook shakes his hook in anger, and he tears poor Tinkerbell's wing. Hook and Smee do everything they can to stop the Jolly Roger sinking to the watery depths below. Peter Pan rips off Captain Hook's cape, and he doesn't even notice. They see their chance and make their escape. Pirates are nothing without their ships. They simply cannot live on land. Then Captain Hook hears the dreaded tick-tock, tick-tock of the crocodile. But this time, it isn't Peter Pan. Here he comes! He swims closer and closer and closer. Captain Hook and Smee climb the mast as quickly as they can. And to this day, they are still there, waiting for the crocodile to swim away. Peter Pan vows to keep Captain Hook's cape forever, so he will never forget this day. He is so happy they have defeated him. But poor Tinkerbell is very upset. She may never fly again.
Don't cry, Tink, says Peter. I know just what to do. Every boy and every girl must shout, I believe in fairies, as loud as they can and clap their hands 3 times.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
I believe in fairies!
They shout. Oh no! It hasn't worked.
Let's try again,
says Peter.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. I believe in fairies!
They shout. Then, just like magic, Tinkerbell's wing is healed. She is so happy she can fly again.
I think we should have a party to celebrate,
says Peter Pan, and everyone agrees. It is the most wonderful party Wendy and Michael have ever been to. Peter Pan has thought of everything. They tuck into scrumptious jelly and ice cream. Tinkerbell and Peter Pan just love to dance. And so do Wendy and Michael. They feel quite worn out after all that dancing. So Wendy reads a bedtime story. In no time at all, Peter Pan and Tinkerbell fall fast asleep. It's time for Wendy and Michael to go home to bed. They take one last look at Neverland before crawling through the little mouse hole. Wendy and Michael are back in their very ordinary bedroom. They miss their new friends terribly. But it is very nice to be home. And it is very nice to be tucked into bed.
One more story, please, Wendy,
says Michael.
It's too late,
says Wendy.
It's past our bedtime. Go on, please,
says Michael.
Peter Pan and Tinkerbell would want you to.
Suddenly, they hear the tinkle of tiny little bells. It can only be Tinkerbell. Wendy just has to read one more story.